Hello everyone, we are going to learn lipoproteins. This is again complex lipids or compound lipids. So lipoproteins means they are made up of lipids plus protein. Lipids could be triglycerides or cholesterol or cholesterol ester or phospholipids. Unlike carbohydrates and proteins, all these lipids, they are not water soluble or water miscible. Then there is a difficulty in transport of these lipids from one organ to another organ, since they are not water miscible or water soluble. So that is why these lipids must be complex with proteins. So these proteins acts as a vehicle or carrier. So in this way, these lipids can be transported. Imagine this is a blood vessels. So in the blood, these lipids cannot be transported because they are not water soluble. But when they complex with proteins, they can easily transported from one organ to another organ. So these proteins which helps in transport of these lipids are called apoprotein or apolipoprotein. So this apolipoprotein actually acts as a vehicle or carrier for this lipid. So when this apoprotein combines with all these lipids in a certain manner, then we call lipoprotein. So they are nothing but transport form of lipids. So in our body, there are mainly two sites where exactly these apolipoproteins are produced. So we know that in our diet, whatever lipids we are taking, they are digested by digestive enzymes. Imagine this is one intestinal mucosal cell. In our body, there are two factory or there are two sites where exactly these lipoproteins are synthesized or you can say packaged. So this is one factory, that is intestinal mucosal cell. Another site is liver. Okay, whatever dietary lipids, they are digested in our intestine by pancreatic lipase or enzymes released from the pancreas. Then they are taken or internalized to intestinal mucosal cell. And again in the intestinal mucosal cell, so these phospholipids, triglycerides, free cholesterol, cholesterol ester, all these are packaged. And there will be addition of this protein called apolipoprotein. And now this is a form of lipoprotein, it is called chylomicron. So then only these lipids can be transported to circulation. So these chylomicron will be taken to lymphatic, then it will go to thoracic duct, then it will enter portal circulation. So the chylomicron directly will not go to circulation, it will go to taken to lymphatic, then to the thoracic duct, then to the circulation. So this intestinal mucosal cell acts as a factory for production of lipoprotein, because this protein, this is apoprotein, which is synthesized in the intestinal mucosal cell. Similarly, there is another factory site where exactly these lipoproteins are produced, that is liver, because liver can produce fatty acid, cholesterol and phospholipid, triglyceride, and fatty acid and cholesterol combined to give cholesterol ester. So all these are packaged and some amount of apoproteins are produced in liver. So they are also packaged in this combination of lipids and protein. Now it will be released into the circulation and it is released as VLDL or very low density lipoprotein. So it will hand over some amount of goods to the extrahepatic tissue, it will be converted to low density lipoprotein. Again, it will be either taken to liver or it will be handover to extrahepatic tissue. In our body, there are two major sites where exactly lipoproteins are produced. Whatever dietary lipid, that is exogenous lipids, they are processed and packaged in intestinal mucosal cell. So such lipoproteins are called chylomicrons, and whatever endogenously produced lipids, especially in the liver, they are packaged and released to the circulation in the form of very low density lipoprotein, and it will be donating its some amount of lipid by some enzymatic reaction, and it will be converted to low density lipoprotein. Again, it can be taken to liver and extrahepatic tissue. Apart from this, we have another lipoprotein called HDL or high density lipoprotein. So again, for synthesis of this high density lipoprotein, we require intestinal mucosal cell as well as liver. Okay, that we will discuss in lipoprotein metabolism. So why I am telling all this, because this is just an introduction. You should know the lipoproteins are transport form of lipids, or in other words, lipids are transported as lipoproteins. Lipids are transported as lipoprotein. Okay, we'll see the classification of lipoproteins. So lipoproteins are broadly classified into chylomicrons, very low density lipoprotein, LDL or low density lipoprotein, and HDL or high density lipoprotein. So these lipoproteins are classified mainly based on ultracentrifugation. That means if you take blood sample and centrifuge and collect only serum, again you centrifuge with the high speed, you can see the topmost layer is chylomicron, because the density of chylomicron is very, very less, which is rich in lipids. So it will float on the top. Then comes very low density lipoprotein. Again, low density lipoprotein, and high density lipoprotein will occupy the bottom because it has got high density. It is rich in protein. So based on ultracentrifugation, lipoproteins are classified into, means based on their density, chylomicron, which will float on the top, their density is least. Chylomicron has got least density compared to all lipoprotein because we are rich in lipids, especially triglyceride. Then very low density lipoprotein, then low density lipoprotein. High density lipoprotein is density is more because it's rich in protein, especially apolipoproteins. So it will settle at the bottom. Another way of classifying lipoprotein is by doing electrophoresis. If you collect blood centrifuge and take the serum and put on a glass slide where the medium is agar or agarose, then apply electricity with the help of buffer, connecting to the buffer. If you apply sample here, so high density lipoprotein moves fastest because it contains more of protein. We know that all proteins are made up of amino acid. They are charged, so it will move fast. So it will occupy a bond called alpha. So HDL or high density lipoprotein, on the basis of electrophoresis, we can tell it is alpha lipoprotein. Then before LDL, you can see here LDL is called beta. Between alpha and beta, there is a band which occupied by very low density lipoprotein. It occupies before beta, so we call it as pre-beta lipoprotein. So pre-beta lipoprotein is nothing but VLDL, then LDL. We know that chylomicron is rich in triglycerides. Usually triglycerides are neutral, simple lipids, they are uncharged. So they will not migrate much. So they will occupy at the point of application of serum sample. Okay. So there are two ways we can classify lipoproteins. One is chylomicron, VLDL, LDL, HDL based on ultracentrifugation. Another way is based on electrophoresis, alpha, beta and pre-beta. This is with respect to classification of lipoprotein. So now we will see the general structure of lipoprotein. We know that there are four types of lipoprotein, but their common structure is same, only the concentration will be different. So let me write the general structure of lipoprotein. So lipoprotein has got central dense core made up of triglycerides. That means it has got glycerol backbone and three fatty acids. So the central dense core is made up of triacylglycerol and the cholesterol ester. This is, imagine this is a cholesterol, then there is addition of fatty acid, so that will become cholesterol ester. And in the periphery, they have monolayer of phospholipids. These are all monolayer of phospholipids. And also in between, you can see free cholesterol. They are not cholesterol ester, free cholesterol. So this is the general structure of lipoprotein. So we will label this. So in the central dense core is made up of triacylglycerol and the cholesterol ester. And in the periphery, they are made up of monolayer of phospholipid. If you take any membrane, plasma membrane or mitochondrial membrane or any subcellular membrane, it is lipid bilayer. But in lipoprotein, it is monolayer phospholipids. And we have free cholesterol. So these are all lipids. They are packaged. You can see all these phospholipids, triacylglycerol, cholesterol ester and free cholesterol, whether they are derived from the diet or synthesized within the liver. So they are packaged like this. There is a central dense core made up of triacylglycerol and cholesterol ester and the periphery monolayer of phospholipids as well as free cholesterol. Now the protein part, which we call apolipoprotein, are surrounded like this. So these are the protein part. They are called apolipoprotein, or simply you can call apoprotein. If you take, there are major four classes of lipoprotein like chylomicron, VLDL, LDL and HDL. All lipoproteins differ with respect to composition, the concentration, the amount of lipids and the type of apoprotein. So general structure of lipoprotein, they are made up of central dense core of triacylglycerol and cholesterol ester and surrounded by monolayer of phospholipids and free cholesterol, and they have different apolipoproteins. So what are apoproteins actually? So apoproteins are nothing but they are protein component of the lipoprotein. So apoproteins are mainly, there are four classes: A, apoprotein A, apoprotein B, apoprotein C or apolipoprotein E. But in few textbook they have mentioned apoprotein D also, but I am not going to explain. So these are the four major classes of apolipoproteins. Now again there are subclasses. Apolipoprotein A, we have apolipoprotein A1 and apolipoprotein A2. Similarly, apolipoprotein B, we have B48 and B100. Apolipoprotein C again classified into C1, C2, C3. Now you should know where exactly these apolipoproteins are synthesized in our body. So it's very easy to remember. Just you remember, all apolipoproteins are synthesized in liver except B48. So this B48 is synthesized only in intestinal mucosal cell. Okay, you need to remember all apolipoproteins are synthesized in liver except B48, because B48 is synthesized only in intestine. Again, there is an exception. This A1 is synthesized in liver as well as intestine. Intestine in the sense intestinal mucosal cell. And you need to remember two important sentences here. All apolipoproteins are synthesized in liver except B48, which is synthesized only in intestine, and A1, which is synthesized in liver as well as in the intestine. Now, the important functions, we know that protein component of lipoprotein. Also, they act as a ligand. Apolipoprotein, they act as a ligand. What do you mean by ligand? We know that lipoproteins are transport form of lipids, right? So, that means these lipids are transported from one organ to another organ. Now, if I take, imagine this is a liver. We already studied liver packages and produce VLDL. And it will be converted to LDL. Okay, this all happens in blood. Now this LDL, which will be either taken to liver or it will be handover to extrahepatic tissue. Remember, in both this tissue there is a receptor called LDL receptor. Okay, so these receptor will not take LDL without the apolipoprotein. In this case, LDL has got only one apolipoprotein, that is B100. Now this B100 apolipoprotein acts as a ligand. So this LDL receptor recognizes only this B100 apoprotein, not LDL. So without B100 apoprotein, LDL cannot be taken to liver or extrahepatic tissue through the LDL receptor. So ligand means they have binding of the receptor and internalize of the lipoprotein. So this is a very important functions of lipoprotein. And also another functions of lipoprotein is they activates or inhibits enzymes. So I will give one example here. So remaining we will study in lipoprotein metabolism. For example, apolipoprotein C2, which actually stimulates lipoprotein lipase enzyme, which helps in hydrolysis of triglyceride. Okay, this is one example. Like that, some of the apoprotein can inhibit some enzyme. Okay, so you need to remember three important functions of apolipoprotein. They act as a ligand or recognition of apoprotein to the receptor and binding and internalization of the lipoprotein, activation or inhibition of enzymes, and they are protein component of lipoprotein. Now we will see the different component of lipoproteins. If you compare all these apoproteins, chylomicron, VLDL, LDL and HDL, chylomicrons are rich in triglycerides. So that is why their density is least and their size is more, even though they are big lipoprotein, but they float on the top because they are rich in lipids. And you need to remember the major apolipoprotein of chylomicron is B48. Okay, because we know that chylomicron is produced in intestinal mucosal cell and B48 is also produced in intestinal mucosal cell. Along when it reaches circulation, it acquires apolipoprotein C, apolipoprotein E from the HDL, and also we know that apolipoprotein A1 is synthesized in intestine as well as liver. And if you take LDL here, we say LDL is actually bad cholesterol. If you compare all these different lipoprotein here, LDL has got highest amount of cholesterol ester. Okay, this VLDL which is released from the liver, it will be converted to LDL and it will deposit whatever fatty acids or cholesterol to the peripheral tissue through LDL receptor. So it is bad cholesterol and it is high in cholesterol ester, and also you can see high in free cholesterol. If you take HDL, it has got maximum amount of protein, and the major apolipoprotein of HDL is ApoA1. So now you can see A1 is synthesized in liver as well as intestine. So that is why the synthesis of HDL requires intestinal mucosal cell as well as liver. So HDL is called good cholesterol not because of high protein content, because HDL actually removes whatever cholesterol or lipids present in the peripheral tissue and hand over to the liver. It is reverse cholesterol transport. So whatever unwanted cholesterol present in the peripheral tissue, HDL takes it and hand over to the liver. Whereas LDL, whatever cholesterol it will deposit in the peripheral tissue. That is why it is called bad cholesterol. So in this picture, you should remember the major apolipoprotein of chylomicron is B48 and it is rich in triglyceride. The LDL is bad cholesterol because it contains maximum amount of 37% of cholesterol ester, and HDL is good cholesterol because it takes cholesterol from the peripheral tissue and handovers to the liver. It is called reverse cholesterol transport system. And LDL contains only one apolipoprotein, that is B100. VLDL contains B100 as well as apolipoprotein C. So these are the difference between different lipoprotein. So this is with respect to lipoproteins, their structure and functions. Thanks for watching.